next song comes straight from Psalm 51. It's an old Steve Green song. We're going to do it a little bit differently, though. We're going to, it's kind of a short piece, so we're going to actually say the psalm at the end of each chorus, so you're not caught by surprise with that. But there's one part in this that stands out to me. It's in verse 2 of Psalm 51 where he says, "Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin." And the word "thoroughly" just kind of stands out to me. Because I find myself sometimes, you know, thinking about, you know, some of the stuff that I've seen and done, whether it be, you know, inappropriate material in the past of my life, whether it be some of the violent things I've seen or whatever. And those images sometimes still exist for you, you know, in your mind and stuff, and you want to get rid of them. And what it means to be thoroughly cleansed, to be thoroughly washed from your sin. That he makes us a new creation, and we wear white garments that cannot be soiled, that cannot be stained. Amen? So, I think that would be a good prayer for all of us, that he would search us, and that he would cleanse us thoroughly, that he would remove all these things that continue to try to plague our minds, that the enemy tries to use against us to get us to either doubt or to feel insufficient or to hinder our bearing of fruit. So.
Oh God, amen.
This next song is written by John Newton. If you haven't had a chance to check out his testimony, it's definitely worth the time. Slave trader amongst a lot of other really rotten things, and this song is a testament of the grace the Lord poured out upon his life, and it's the same grace that still exists for us today. Thank you, Lord.
Divine, my own, let me be as gold. is to